So, Shabad mantras are very powerful, but you must be initiated in them. Okay. So, somebody asked, why do I have to be initiated into mantras by gurus? Why can't I just read the mantras all by myself? This was asked by a king to a yogi. And the yogi told the king's guards, kill that guy, kill him, kill that guy sitting on the throne. And then the king got pissed off because the guy's going on asking the guards to kill him. And he said, hey, arrest this fellow. Put him in jail for 10 days. Let's see what he says. Immediately they caught him and they're taking him away. I said, listen, when you said it, they did right. When I said they didn't do anything right, that's why when you get mantras from a guru, he has the status to use those mantras. Otherwise, they're just sounds. Nobody's going to listen. I also made sounds, kill this guy. They didn't respond to those sounds. The universe is not going to respond to your sounds just because you read it in one book you got in the railway station that said Shabar mantras. That's not how you receive Shabar mantras. You have to receive it from a guru. And then when you receive it from a guru, then it has its effect. Otherwise, you're just like not going to be able to cure anything. Okay? And you'll be surprised that the Shabar mantras, actual ones, are different from what you receive in the railway station from some hawker on the street. That's not where you get Shabar mantras from. Okay, that's about Shabar mantras. Let's see. What is the Kaula branch of yoga? Kaula means Kula plus Akula. Kula is your Kundalini and Akula is everything else. And a person who can enjoy Kula and Akula together is a Kaula. Nath is a yoga school of immortality. And Kaula is just a concept in Tantra. It's not a school. Okay? It's not a branch of yoga. It's a branch of Tantra. Discourses given from Bhairava to Bhairavi or Bhairavi to Bhairava. Bhairava to Bhairavi, they're called Agamas, and Bhairavi to Bhairava, they're called Nigamas. So there are 64 such tantras. Nobody has the textbooks except my teacher, the 64 textbooks of Tantra. Nobody has the complete textbooks. They've got half and half and half and piece, piece, piece here. With those pieces only, these fools like Woodruff and who's that other guy? Author Avalon, who, and then some. Who's a guy who calls himself the most evil beast? All these clowns, okay? A lot of Western clowns came and then started writing books about it. And then Indians came to know from the Western clowns that, oh, we have all this in India. Because Indians were so busy licking their boots, okay? And then, that's how Kaula became a branch of yoga. Loosely, anything has happened. And the Indian today doesn't even know Sanskrit, cannot even read, can't even pronounce. And all the textbooks are written in Sanskrit. But it's okay, you don't need textbooks. Forget the textbooks, you need a teacher. The Indians have forgotten how to respect teachers, they respect Dongi Babas. They don't know who's a real teacher. They don't know. Because real teacher will slap you. Real teacher will never tell you you're amazing and then give you something to feel good, no? A real teacher will never make you feel good. You'll always feel on edge. You'll always feel challenged when you go to a real teacher. You can never feel good. Then you know you're in a real teacher's presence. Because you'll be uncomfortable every day. He'll be pushing you to do some uncomfortable things every day. Okay? But people want comfort. They want a blanket. They're confused between a teacher and a blanket. A teacher's job is opposite of blanket. Blanket is to make you comfortable. A teacher's job is to keep slapping you and then keep making you uncomfortable, allowing you to suffer and see and say, now are you ready to learn? Now are you ready to learn? Now are you ready to learn? Teachers have infinite patience. Kabir used to, I mean, one of my teachers called Ibrahim, okay? He's a Persian immortal. And he was Kabir's student. And Kabir followed him like for three births. Yeah, three births. They were in quick succession. He died, then he was born as a buffalo for some time, and then within 2 years he was eaten, and then his skin became a drum, and then he was in the drum. That's his third birth, and that got cut within 1 week, and then his soul got released, and it became a prince in Persia, prince of Persia. And then in four births, so Kabir kept on asking, 4 births, have you had enough? Do you want to learn? Even when he became a prince, he asked, have you had enough now? You want to learn? You got human body again. You want to waste this or you want to take it? Right. So teachers follow you around for births sometimes. All right. So what is this Kala branch of yoga? It's not a branch of yoga. It's a branch of tantra. It's a concept in tantra where we work with kundalini, and then you use kundalini shakti to influence everything that is not kundalini shakti. So it's kula plus akula becomes kala. That's basically what it is. What is Kundalini Shakti? It is Shakti who separated herself from Shiva. She doesn't want to be part of Shiva. She separated herself. And it's very much required. Okay? If you think the ideal of a marriage is Ardhanarishvara, we'll be joined at the hip. That's good when you're having sex. After that, please unjoin yourself from the hip. And have a life of your own. That is Shakti. Okay, she's trying to have a life of her own without Shiva. That is Kundalini. But people don't understand that's Kundalini. They want to beat Kundalini and make her merge with Shiva again. That is not Kala. That is stupidity. Okay, so there are a lot of stupid things also written in text. This is written in a textbook. That you had to beat Kundalini and make her go merge with Shiva on the top floor or on top of your head. And then the Western guys copied it. Where? What is Yoga Upanishads? Can anyone respect Yoga Upanishads? No, they were just written for the sake of it. They're not really that based in real yoga or immortal yoga. They don't understand anything. They're just talking. There are a lot of textbooks that are based out of the Yoga Upanishad. So people read whatever textbook is easy to read. Like Patanjali's Yoga Sutra, only 196 words, let's read it. Okay, but there's a lot before that also which happened. And Patanjali has a volume of writings in Tamil. Has anyone bothered to read it? No. So, yeah, that's the answer for this question. Okay. Hope you got your answer, Abhinav.